Be the change you want to see in the world. A revolution often starts with one person, and the one person in this case is Eric Briggs, reporting analyst in the call center division of a Fortune 1000 company. Now, he saw what was going on with reporting in his company, lots of different reports, all disconnected from each other, most just spewing out numbers, not really useful. And you know you need help when you have an Excel report tracking all the other Excel reports. Now that's not you, is it? Now listen to how Eric introduced Power BI, not just to clean house and consolidate reports, but go beyond the numbers to answering questions that really matter. It's stories like Eric that get me excited. Stories from real people, just like you and me, using Power BI to make a real impact. These are the Power BI pioneers. I would also love to hear about your Power BI journey, so share that in the comments below. And make sure to subscribe and click the bell so you don't miss a thing. Let's hear it from Eric. Hey, Eric, how are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I am doing great. Well, certainly glad to be here with you.
As am I.
Terrific. So let's get started. Tell me about how Power BI is being used in your company around call center reporting. Yeah, tell me about that.
We're using it for call center reporting, agent level, queue level, getting a good indicator of what our top drivers might be, what it could look like next year, and really just getting down to the nuts and bolts of what's driving the calls and maybe what areas of focus, need to be addressed.
Wow.
Such as escalations, queue escalations. I don't think we've ever really, up until now, been able to look at the time of a case has been open and then interactively filter that with, time of year, case type, customer, that sort of thing.
Yeah, love that. Oh boy. So I already heard a little bit of that in the, what you just said, but still tell me, how is this different than how it was being done differently? I'm sure the call center has been around a long time. I'm sure people have been churning out reports a long time. How is this any different?
Well, any different? I'm going to say probably the biggest impact is because we cover a wide variety of drivers or just reporting in general. We had so many freaking Excel reports. It was insane. I mean, we even had a list to track all of the reoccurring ones, who they go to, time of year, that sort of thing. The thing that I saw the most potential with Power BI in itself was just that. It effectively eliminates and consolidates a lot of that. Uh-huh. Into just a few different models, and it makes it so much easier to manage. Yeah. The other thing is because, large company people have their own way they want to look at the data. So it was common occurrence for people to request some kind of ad hoc report, to have to pull the data, modify it how they wanted to see it, and then send it off to them. Power BI takes that away, and it effectively lets them slice it however they want, and the question's already been answered. It's just a matter of them going in there and looking at it.
Wow, that's pretty cool. Okay, so I definitely want to ask you more about that, but let's backtrack a bit and maybe tell me a bit about your journey, maybe at this company, maybe prior to that, that what brought you to that? What brought you to Power BI?
So creating most of my reports, in Excel, I've always been exposed to Power Pivot. Didn't really use it. Hindsight now, I probably should have. How I got started was a team member of mine said, "Oh, hey, this is kind of like a visual way you can pull a query from a SQL database." I'm no SQL wizard, right? It's kind of funny how that was described, but I'm no SQL wizard. I know the basic stuff, can get what I need from there. So I decided, heck, well, I'll check it out. Well, after jumping in there, this is maybe 8 months ago, hasn't even been a year.
What?
after jumping in there, I quickly saw the potential and I got the free trial, which I think was only like 30 days or something, but I was able to get enough out and show it to enough, managers and people above me that I started getting some attention. And, I had a couple people ask me to create reports for other departments. So, I was doing that and I got a couple of them hooked. I was worried, well, once the license is out, the show is kind of over, but I was able to have them put some money down. We got five licenses, so only a few of us have it, and but they're currently evaluating how we're going to deploy it, large scale. So
That's
that's
great.
all you need. That's all you need is just the hook. For anyone that's in this situation, you just need the fish hook.
Seeing is believing, right? You know, I mean, somebody can come in and show you the best of demos, you see it with your own data, and it turns heads, right? So that's great. That's pretty amazing you've been able to pull that off. So one question I want to ask you is that, sure, I mean, it's funny how it was described to you initially, like visual way, and a lot of people fixate on that, like the visual end. And of course, when you're showing it to somebody, management or somebody else, they only see the visual. That's what you show them. But what do you think about the part about what's under the hood and building the model?
So that is something I was never exposed to before for data modeling. And I'm glad that it's in there because I mean it's not just related to Power BI, but I mean it's any kind of background with databases. It exposed me to that world, which is something I've always wanted to dive into, but never got the chance. The connectors alone in Power BI, it's flexible and it's vast enough that no matter where your data is at, you can get it. And that's the thing that I love. It's anywhere and
I mean, the more I look around, I see that the problems are kind of universal. I mean, every company pretty much, you look at the analyst role or somebody in the business area, they're struggling with pulling data from multiple sources and combining them, cleaning it, and it just does that so easily. And of course, goes beyond that, all the measures and all the stuff, right? So that's great. What about, was there any resistance that you encountered? Some naysayers or somebody who brushed it aside? Did you encounter any of that?
I mean, there were some that, they thought, oh, this was cool, but don't really see the full potential of it. And I mean, that was probably my biggest frustration is I knew the potential was there. It was just getting them to see it. And there was one dashboard that I worked really long on, and I didn't even it wasn't even my own department that finally flipped the switch. It was one of our I guess you could say our sister departments. They help us, we help them sort of thing. I got the manager over there hooked, and then from there he started showing my department lead, and he's like, oh, well, okay, well maybe there is something here.
Pretty cool. I have had the similar experience, not just my own story, but I use the term Power BI pioneers, right? These people who are pushing, Power BI kind of at the edge and trying to evangelize it within their team organization. But the story I've seen is that inevitably they kind of rise up. They rise above and beyond just their own team. I mean, they inevitably get connected with other members. And my story is that I don't know, I was a business analyst and kind of heads down kind of guy, just doing my own thing. But after discovering Power BI, I started doing brown bags. That's so uncharacteristic of me. Like, what? Right? So, but I hear some of that in your story too, that it just seemed like organically it happened that you got in touch with other people and started working with them.
That's exactly right.
Okay, pretty cool. So, hey, I want to end this back where we started, talking about the reporting, Power BI reports that you guys are using at call centers. Now, I use this phrase, you've probably heard it before, where peeling the onion. And you start off with something really basic. And what's mind-bending is what's basic in Power BI could be still really, really cool and mind-blowing in the old world. But it certainly seems that you have gone on, you have pushed the envelope there,
in terms of pushing beyond and looking deeper and deeper. Tell me a little bit about that journey. I mean, how long has it taken? Has it been kind of back and forth? Tell me a little bit about that. How have things evolved over time?
You just like learning Power BI in general?
Well, so how do you go back and forth? Like, if you have clients, do you give them a report and they come back with reports? I just want to hear from you, like, how has that experience been? How has that journey been?
It's been pretty good overall. I mean, the biggest challenge, I think, is me just having to learn the new tool, right? Mm-hmm. When you're first starting out with Power BI, it goes easy. Yeah. Then extremely difficult, and then it's easy again. I couldn't have said it better.
Bingo. I mean, I've gone through the same curve, and I've seen so many others. So I get it. I think it's easy. You start off just with the visuals, then you get hit with some of the DAX and M stuff. But you know, it's not hard. Once you figure that out, then it opens so many more possibilities for you, right?
Mm-hmm. So I mean, there's I guess to go back to that is there's some things that people would it was done this way in Excel. Can I have it look like this?
Yeah.
Power BI, it's you can get that, but why? You can get something so much more if you do it, you know, the Power BI way, right? I think change for audience can be difficult sometimes, but really just keep pushing, and eventually they're gonna see that it's better, and that's what I'm starting to experience.
Yeah. Oh man, this is the good stuff, my friend. So I'll quote one of my other friends, and he talked about change and managing change. And you know, it's funny. I mean, in a way, it's not really about Power BI. Power BI is a means to an end, and it's a tool, but it's still an enabler. And every Power BI pioneer that I've talked to, they talk about this people and kind of working with them. So that other friend of mine, he talked about that they don't fear change, they fear loss, right? I mean, loss of whatever, you know, safety, security you have and so forth. So one trick that I sometimes use is, and I don't know, maybe you tell me if you use this, that if they say, yeah, I want this is my Excel report or whatever, something they're getting from SSRS exported or something, just give me that. And I'll try to give them that as close as I can. And I'll say, yeah, here you go. This is what you asked for. Oh, by the way, just this other thing. Here's this visual, and you know, I give them something graphical, and it's all interactive, and you don't have to use it. You know, just try it out. Have you pulled that off in time?
Yeah, I have. And actually, some kind of similar is people like, well, I like to see the data. When you send Excel, I have the data there. I was like, well, here, I'll provide you this visual, but if you want to see the underlying data, click these three dots, and there you go. It's the same thing, just we didn't have to send it to you in an Excel sheet.
All right. Hey, this has been great. So last question I'm going to ask you is that you talked about that Power BI is easy and then it gets really hard and then it gets easy again. What would you say to somebody who's stuck on that uphill climb and say, oh, gosh, this is so hard, and they're about to give up?
For me, you know, I've always been a self-help kind of guy. And actually the first time I've ever really considered doing a class was for this, because I hit a brick wall and I couldn't get over it. You know, there's just some things that you can't learn on your own. You need a push. And if you're stuck, go through a training, read, you know, do something, get an instructor help, I guess a mentor. And that's what I did, and I'm so happy I did, because I don't think I would have ever. Well, I mean, maybe I would have, but it would have been frustrating and nail biting experience. So,
what's waiting for them on the other side, though?
Bliss. It's happiness. I mean, just not having to manually send out reports is a godsend. That's awesome. You know, answering most of people's questions or concerns. Power BI does that already by itself. You don't have to do a side little report for them. It just makes maintaining and doing everything so much easier.
Awesome. Eric, thank you so much for your time today. I really enjoyed our conversation. Thank you, man.
You're very welcome. Thank you.
Hey, so what did you think? My favorite moment was when Eric talked about the Excel report being used to track all the other Excel reports. What was your favorite moment? Let me know. And if you would like to join Eric inside the Learn Power BI family, there is information in the details below. Power on, my friend.